So we are going to do PRP for hair today. Patient is ready for his blood extraction. Tourniquet is being tied. You disinfect the area first. Ask the patient to make a fist always. So normally we would like about 7 ml of blood to be removed, 7 to 10 ml. Now the tubes that we have are 8 ml tubes for PRP, which has biotin as well in it. So we will be removing about 7 ml of blood from him. Alright, so as you can see, I'm going in now. So this is about 7.5 to 8 ml of blood. Now the tube that we have is an 8 ml tube. So I will be only putting around 7.5 ml in it. So now I have my blood in the PRP tube and I want to centrifuge it. I have only one tube. So I'm gonna counter it with a separate tube, which is only plain water. You keep it in the centrifuge, close, start your centrifuge. Keep your centrifuge on 5 for exactly 10 minutes. So while your PRP is being prepared, it's very important to clean the surface area that you're going to treat. We will be cleaning it now with betadine first. So I'm doing his frontal region, so I'll be only cleaning up this part. If you have a patient with complete forehead treatment, then you can go ahead with that as well. So you clean with betadine and keep it for 3 minutes. And then you re-clean it with sterile water. So this is the PRP that has been made. This is the IPPP. Okay, the gel has separated it out. Now I will show you how to extract it. So this is the IPPP. I'm gonna now remove it. Basically the platelet-rich plasma. I prefer removing it first in a bigger syringe and then putting it in the insulin syringe for injectable. These are insulin syringes. Now I'm gonna fill it up. So from about 7.5 ml of blood that we extracted, we got 3 insulin syringes that we can inject into his scalp. That's about 3 ml and there is also 0.5 ml still remaining. So make the patient comfortable as much as you can and then start injecting. So now I will be doing it with the dermarola. I've already given him the injectable. Part his hair properly so that it doesn't, normally with a derma roller you have chances of pulling the hair a lot, so always make sure that the hair is flat before you start with the process. Apply some of your PRP, hold the hair on two sides and go ahead and roll. You will take it layer by layer. Add your PRP, then roll the derma roller on the PRP. Now remember, while PRP scalp, when you're doing with a derma roller, you don't have to cause any pinpoint bleeding because you don't want healing. So you can be as soft as possible. So only that we need the substance to penetrate inside. Rajesh, you had any pain during the procedure?
No.
No, you were comfortable?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so that is the end of the entire PRP for hair procedure. Thank you.